Hello everyone and welcome back to my Forex channel. So in this session I will show how I do my top-down analysis when I'm preparing for the trading session. So in this video I will cover a topic that was requested multiple times from my followers and subscribers. So sit back, relax, take notes if you actually need and let's go. So the top-down analysis helps us as a traders to understand the market conditions in a much better way, what to predict and what we can expect from the market so we will know how to deal that in the future. And most of the time I start my analysis from a monthly, going down to weekly, daily, and on 4-hourly or 1-hourly chart, I'm starting to look for a potential entry. So this is where I'm starting to go more into the news. I'm checking them and I'm waiting for some candle closure as usual to enter the trade. And if you would like to join my Forex group, we have 400 and more people. We are growing fast and we're dominating the market. You will find the link to my group in the description box down below. I like to start analysis with a clean chart on a monthly time frame, and the clean chart helps me to filter out the possible conflicting signals from the indicators on the chart, as I'm only focusing to read the structure of the current market instead of focusing on other indicators and what they're actually telling us. Of course, once you're done with your all analysis, you can add additional indicators, so like moving averages, RSI, MACD, and so much more, which can actually show you another additional confirmation before you entering any kind of trade. So I have USDJPY, and what you want to do is to actually draw horizontal areas of a support and resistance that are close to the current price data. Of course, the trend lines is also very helpful to draw it because we will know what kind of trades we will be looking for. And if you spot any simple or advanced chart patterns, do it and identify it. So like double top, double bottom, maybe the flag pattern, a squeeze pattern, or any kind of type of triangles, do it and mark it as it will help you later on with a trade and entry points. And if you haven't seen the video on how you can master entry and exit points, which you can actually combine with a top-down analysis for a perfect entry opportunities, I will link a pop-up over here so you can go and check it out. So let's analyze the monthly time frame. We do see we having a downtrend made of a series of lower highs. The actual price been bouncing off the trend multiple times, clearly indicating the bearish momentum. Of course, the monthly time frame helps to see the bigger picture. We will have a better perspective of the possible price movements, and we can see our horizontal area of his support. It's also been retested multiple times. Resistance zone, which is over here, is also strong enough by not letting the buyers to push the price further up. So we have a multiple bounces over here as well. And usually when I'm done by analyzing the monthly time frame, I just like to make a text so I will not confuse myself with the loads of areas of sensitivity when I will move to the weekly and daily and 4-hourly charts. So let's go down to the weekly time frame for a quick look. And what we're gonna do on a weekly time frame is basically the same what we have done on a monthly chart. So we're gonna draw areas of sensitivity, any trend lines and chart patterns if you can spot them straight away. So what do we see on a weekly time frame is the actual trend towards the upside going into the squeeze pattern. So you know, when we have a squeeze pattern, we don't know where the price is gonna shoot. This is why we should wait for some kind of break towards the upside or downside, maybe some push and exhaustion to the previous area of sensitivity, some kind of bullish or bearish engulfing candle closure, and then we can enter the trade. So as you can see, I marked horizontal areas of a sensitivity on the weekly time frame. I have spot a channel over here. Again, it's a squeeze pattern, so we don't know where the market actually will go. So as you see, we have a few areas of a resistance based on the price moves in the past. So far the chart looks good to me, so let's go on to the daily chart. So again, on the daily I can definitely see some recent area of a horizontal sensitivity, because basically this was a resistance shoot towards the downside. Again, we just can literally drag it over here. Again, it got touched with the zone shoot towards the downside, respected our trend line, the channel, but of course because of the strong bullish pressure it just broke it, and now it's acting as a support for this trade. And on the 4-hourly chart we can definitely see some bullish trend towards the upside, because every time the price got in touch with a trend line it basically shot towards the upside. As you can see, of course I can spot some horizontal area of a sensitivity as well, because basically it was broken, now it's acting as a support. So let's play a replay tool on to see what will be happening if we will have to wait patiently for this squeeze pattern to end and to see where the market is actually deciding to move on. And as you can see, we have this huge bearish engulfing candle. It broke the 4-hourly support with this huge momentum, so we have the push, now we have to wait for the exhaustion to the previous area of sensitivity where we could actually enter the trade, because we will have a confirmation from the seller side for an entry. And as you can see, if we would drag this down, the 4-hourly is now acting as a resistance. We have the bearish engulfing candle, and now we can enter the trade short for sure. So let's actually see how the top down analysis turned out for us on this bearish move. And of course, as I said, the weekly and the monthly time frames are much stronger than a 4-hourly on a 1-hourly, because we will, as I said, the bigger picture of a higher time frame suggesting us much more data than, let's say, in a shorter time frame. So let's play a replay till on and see how the trade went based on analysis on every single time frame that we can possibly do. And as we can see, this is how the trade went. We definitely reached more than 140. It's nearly 200 pips into the profit only based on the top down analysis. So I hope you found this video helpful to you, and if you did, smash like and comment down below. And once again guys, thank you for watching me, and until next time, bye.